Felicity Huffman is the first parent to be sentenced in the college admission scandal.
The actress received a sentence of 14 days behind bars. She was accused of spending $15,000 to have the scam's mastermind boost her daughter's SAT scores. Huffman pleaded guilty to conspiracy to commit mail fraud and honest services mail fraud. Defense attorney Vikas Bajaj is here with us to discuss what all of that means. Yeah. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you so much.
So, first of all, the sentence, 14 days, a lot of people think that's very light.
Well, it's really a symbolic sentence. In the federal system, we look at a number of things in a marked difference to state court criminal cases. Probably the most important one in federal court is under the umbrella of accepting responsibility in early plea. Mm. And in this case, that's in fact what we saw Ms. Huffman do. She pled guilty. Her PR team did, I think, a masterful job in appeasing the U.S. Attorney's Office to go easy on her, really. And as we see, as we normally see in federal prosecutions, there's a whole, you know, Pandora's box of criminal charges that prosecutors have been investigating, and they are willing to charge against defendants. So many times they give you the double-edged sword. Plead guilty now, and we know you're going to be uncomfortable doing so, or we're going to supersede or add more allegations. And that's, of course, what we saw with Ms. Laughlin with the money laundering charges.
Well, it's interesting you bring her up, because do you think at this point Lori Laughlin is regretting not pleading guilty?
That's very hard to say. That's really a conversation between her and her lawyer. I will tell you, having represented many people in federal court, it is not an anomaly. It is not rare to wait to plead guilty, especially when you have paper charges, money laundering charges, tax fraud charges. There may be some evidentiary issues that their defense team is exploring. There may be issues with searches, subpoenas, entrapment, and we don't know exactly what those may be. So I would caution all of our viewers not to read too much into her not pleading guilty so soon.
Well, and I think part of the problem is that people see the college admission scandal as one big omnibus crime, but the fact of the matter is, what some parents did may very well be worse than what other parents did.
You just hit the nail on the head, and that's exactly what the federal sentencing guidelines look towards. And you're right, we have here, Tony, a conspiracy. Mm-hmm. And within that conspiracy, federal judges say, well, we have 56 people. Now, are you the person that was acting the worst, or are you the person that was acting the best? And because they're all charged within a conspiracy, the federal guidelines allow people who are lesser individuals, lesser actors, not as involved, to be sentenced as a lighter sentence in comparison to those who are, under the statute, managers or leaders. For instance, a person like Mr. Singer in the case we're speaking about.
Wow, interesting insight. Thank you so much, Vikas Bajaj, defense attorney, for coming in and speaking with us. Have a wonderful Monday.
Thank you. My pleasure.
A big discussion still to come.
And we'll hear more. Yeah. And we'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Yeah.